Two massive trade rumors popped up this week, one involving Andre Drummond and the other one Kyle Kuzma. One of these trades would make a team instant title favorites, the other could ruin a franchise. But how the hell did we get here? Everything was great in Lakerland. Kuzma, coming off an injury, was supposed to be the third wheel with AD and LeBron. What could have happened?
Kyle Kuzma's trainer was critical of LeBron.
So random. We may never find out.
Posting on social media that Kawhi's skill set was sharper than LeBron's.
We'll get into that. But what about Drummond? Since the trade rumors came out, people have been trashing this dude's game. Can't they see the box score? Can't they see that he is a walking double-double, maybe the best rebounder since Wilt? There's a reason for the trash talk. We'll get into that. In this video, we will explain all the drama, what the future could hold, and all of the juicy trade scenarios. But first, a really big channel announcement here at AM Hoops. Here it is. His name is Dudley. He is a puppy bulldog. We're trying to get 5,000 likes in honor of the new puppy, the new member of AM Hoops, Dudley. All right, so first, a report came out late last week. Teams are interested in Kyle Kuzma, but of course they're interested in a really talented, salary-controlled guy. So we didn't think a ton of it at first. I mean, he's one of the Lakers' guys. He was their rep at the draft lottery. He's one of Rob Pelinka's few success stories. Then a report came out that the Lakers are listening. Okay, so now it's time to break out trade scenarios. But first, we have to understand Kyle Kuzma's trade value to actually break down trade scenarios. So we talked about the fact that he's a really cost-controlled, talented young player. That looks like 2 years left, year one, 1.9 million bucks this season, and then 3.5 million bucks next season. That is super cheap, but what about the numbers on the court? Well, that's the thing. People kind of assumed that Kyle Kuzma was gonna come in and be the third wheel, but that hasn't exactly panned out. Last season, he averaged 18.7 points, 5.5 boards, 2.5 assists per game, and now just 12.1 points per game, 3.5 boards, and less than 1 assist on a career low 42.5% field goal percentage. He's got 10 games where he only dropped single-digit points, including a big fat zero against Dallas on December 29th. And LA's been better with him off the floor. A 5.1 net rating when he plays and an 8.6 rating when he doesn't. So all that basically means that his trade value has regressed a bit with those numbers. Last year and the year before, maybe he was just a good stats, bad team guy. There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, Kuzma is watching his buddy Brandon Ingram right now being a really good stats on a bad team guy, and Ingram is about to get a max contract. So how should Kuzma feel about possibly being traded? I think his bank account should feel pretty good. And then there is that whole trainer thing. The trainer took to social media and he wrote after that Christmas Day game where the Clippers won, "Watching Kawhi highlights from yesterday, nobody wants to speak on how sharp his skill set is compared to LeBron's. It's clear who's really in the lab and who isn't. Let me hear the excuses. I'm on vacation. I got nothing but time. Turn the film on. Somebody was dodging smoke yesterday and it wasn't Kawhi." So that happened a few weeks ago. I know we're all still processing it, but even a few weeks later, that is an insane thing to say. And I know Kuzma, LeBron, everyone's come out and said, oh, we're all fine, we're all good here in this locker room. But what else are they gonna say? This locker room is now awkward because of the trainer's comments? Of course not. They're gonna say everything's fine, and then quietly Kuzma will just go away. And that's what's happening. All right, so let's get into the trade scenarios. What do the Lakers need right now? They need a wing, 3 and D, and a backup point guard who can score and sort of carry his own in the offense when LeBron James sits. So how can they accomplish both of those things? Well, it'll either be free agency and a buyout, plus this trade to fill both holes. Here's how it could happen. First scenario, Darren Collison as a free agent, there's that backup point guard who can score, and they trade Kyle Kuzma and Boogie Cousins for Jay Crowder of the Memphis Grizzlies. Our second scenario, first they get Andre Iguodala to fill the wing spot in a buyout. This requires some luck, as the Grizzlies have said they prefer to get something back in trade. Then they trade Kyle Kuzma, Boogie Cousins for Derrick Rose. Now this is interesting. Some of you have argued on my last video about All-Stars, I left D. Rose out. A lot of you think that Derrick Rose should be an All-Star. and you actually make a great point, he is playing very well, he could absolutely fill that backup point guard role who can carry the offense. Trade scenario number three, we go back to Darren Collison and free agency, then they trade Kyle Kuzma, Boogie Cousins, Quinn Cook, and Jared Dudley for Marcus Morris. Now that is a ton to give up for Marcus Morris, who's been playing really, really well for the Knicks. Also, Marcus Morris has shown that he can carry his own in the playoffs. He did last year with the Celtics. He's also a physical guy. He can bring defense. These are all reasons that the San Antonio Spurs wanted him. But I understand if some of you shoot that down because it's a lot to give up and a lot of chemistry to mess with for a team who has started off so well. Our last trade scenario is Darren Collison in free agency, and then they get Kyle Kuzma, Boogie Cousins, and Jared Dudley for Robert Covington. Now this one to me feels a little more realistic. The Timberwolves season has cratered with the long losing streak plus Karl Anthony Towns sitting out so much. They could look to flip Robert Covington for the future. They get a good piece there in Kyle Kuzma, and the rest of those contracts are expiring, and it's not too much to give up for the Lakers to mess with that chemistry. I think any of these scenarios make the Lakers instant title favorites. So while the Kyle Kuzma deal seems to be in the pre-stages, even with the deadline coming up, the Andre Drummond thing feels like it could happen at any moment. Adrian Wojnarowski reported that the Pistons and Hawks could be in serious trade talks right now. Then Yahoo threw in the Celtics, Mavericks, and Raptors. And we'll do trade scenarios for all of them. And the Celtics deal is the trickiest. We'll get to it. But first, how did we get here with Andre Drummond? I mean, Pistons owner Tom Gores reportedly loved Andre Drummond. But then he said this, quote, "We have to look at everything because we're not winning. So if you're not winning, you have to assess everything. And that's what we're aspiring to do, something bigger than what we've been doing." And what have they been doing? Playing with a core of Blake Griffin and Andre Drummond. They've seen that ceiling. Blake's a health issue, owed $76 million the next 2 years, so he's staying put. The only logical, realistic thing to do is move Andre Drummond. Besides, he's about to decline his $29 million player option. He'll be a free agent, so they don't want him to walk for nothing if they're not gonna re-sign him. The good news about Drummond, he's only 26 years old. He's about to enter his prime, so they should get back a hefty return, right? I mean, he averages almost 18 points a game, leads the league with almost 16 boards per game. He's healthy. He's missed only 10 total games the last 6 seasons. So why is everyone trashing his game? Well, Andre Drummond's issues can be summed up in one sentence. All that production does not lead to wins. I mean, the proof's right there in the numbers. The Pistons have 0 playoff wins and 1 winning season since he was drafted in 2012. He can hardly shoot despite trying to develop that part of his game. And even with Drummond in the middle, Detroit's been a bottom 10 defense 4 times out of the last 8 years. They're 24th in defensive rating this year, and teams easily score in the paint. That's not supposed to happen with a big guy like Drummond. So why would a team want a huge chunk of their salary cap taken up by a player like that? Because GMs have done crazier things. So therefore, here are some trade scenarios for all of those teams previously mentioned. We'll start with the Atlanta Hawks. The Hawks give up Chandler Parsons and the first round pick they have from Brooklyn that is lottery protected, but as it's going right now, looks like it'll convert because Brooklyn should make the playoffs. Why do the Hawks do this after everything we just went through? Well, they need to get Trae Young help. There's been frustration. There was even one report that after one of their really bad losses this year, Trae Young was beside himself in the locker room, and one of the Hawks front office people went to him to console him and said, "We are gonna get you help, Trae." How can they follow up on that promise? This is one way. Also, it allows them to re-sign Drummond if they want to, because they'll have his bird rights. But they've got the space to sign Drummond this summer, so they don't have to get desperate with their offer. Second scenario. The Raptors trade Marc Gasol and a 2020 first round pick. The Raptors do this to see if Drummond is gonna work beside Pascal Siakam, Fred VanVleet, and the rest of their young core. Gasol's expiring deal makes the money work, and the first round pick is an asset to make the trade worth it for Detroit. Again, I don't expect people to give up too much for Andre Drummond. I know it doesn't seem like a lot, but this makes sense. That means I'd expect the Mavericks to be able to pull off a trade with just Courtney Lee's contract, Dwight Powell, and a second round pick. Lee's money makes this thing work, and Dwight Powell is the next center in Detroit under team control for four more years. Dallas is already a strong rebounding team, but having a physical presence in the paint could be useful aside Luka Doncic and Kristaps Porzingis. Actually, the Mavericks are one of the few teams I could talk myself into Drummond actually being a part of their core. I don't think Drummond could be the best or second best player on a title team, but maybe the third best, and he certainly would be that in Dallas. And the last team here is Boston. But here's the deal with the Celtics. Andre Drummond makes so much money that they would have to move either Gordon Hayward or Marcus Smart plus three other guys to make this work, and I do not see them doing that. The fact is, Danny Ainge didn't want to break up this core for the better AD, Anthony Davis. What would make us think he would break up this core for Andre Drummond? He wouldn't. So those are two giant trade rumors. And again, I think Drummond going to any team and them re-signing him for max space would wreck that team. They would become the new Pistons on the road to mediocrity. While I think this could be an opportunity for the Lakers to fill both needs to be instant title favorites.
Support AM Hoops and click subscribe. Don't miss a weekly NBA video.